In this segment of the female reproductive system, we're going to be discussing the ova and its development. What we're going to be discussing when we talk about egg development, we're really talking about oogenesis. So oogenesis is the development or the production of the ova, okay, which is the gamete for the females. All right, now oogenesis actually occurs in three different phases. There's the fetal phase of oogenesis. There's prior to ovulation, which occurs at puberty. So this is what starts at puberty. And then there's the third phase called after fertilization. So we're going to work our way through each one of these phases. So we're going to start off with the oogonia in fetal development. The oogonia is diploid. It's 2N. And this is considered the germ cell in the female reproductive tract. So the oogonia undergoes mitosis during fetal development. And remember that the oogonia are fixed. The number of those are fixed. And so once the oogonia undergo mitosis, then some of these will actually begin meiosis. So meiosis begins during fetal development. Meiosis may begin, but it does not. It's not completed during fetal development. It is only beginning. So during fetal development, the primary oocyte is produced, and that's produced through meiosis. And then that primary oocyte is going to do what's called a mitotic arrest. So the baby has been born, the baby now reaches puberty. At puberty, meiosis one is completed. Now let's think about this for a minute. Okay, when I say meiosis one is completed, what we're saying is that at puberty, one primary oocyte per month completes meiosis one. So when meiosis one is completed, a secondary oocyte, which if you notice is haploid, and a polar body. Polar bodies disintegrate, so we won't worry about polar bodies. They're not important. The secondary oocyte is what leaves the ovary and enters into the uterine tube. So when the secondary oocyte gets into the uterine tube, one of two things can happen. Fertilization could occur, considering there's sperm in the uterine tube, or fertilization might not happen. If no fertilization occurs, then the secondary oocyte will continue to pass through the rest of the uterine tube, through the uterus, and out the body. If fertilization does take place, now meiosis II occurs. And once meiosis II occurs, then we're going to produce an ovum. And we get a second polar body as well. Polar bodies, remember, disintegrate, so we won't worry about those. On the oogenesis diagram, then, this last path or phase is after fertilization.